got the boot. I got the boot. Can you see? Can you see? Hi. Hi, Lauren.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, my God. Hi, Marina. Hi, Rebecca.
Lucky Lauren.
You guys. Steve-o. Oh, my God. You have been so awesome. Hello. Still have the suit. Michael's going to wear it a little bit later in the show.
Only the bottoms. Hey,
Tamara might get mad.
What? So how are you getting this back to Tamara?
Tamara, who is so awesome, right? This chickie who lives in Toronto, and she, I guess, goes as the Pink Ranger to a lot of different Comic-Con conventions and stuff. Right. Loaned me her suit for our crazy stunt.
That was so good.
And Michael showed up. Thank God. Michael showed
up. I just
up.
Showed up for the last song. I didn't know that it was... I thought you guys were, like, on your way. And then I got there and you'd already been singing.
I already sang. You guys, I rocked it, man. I just stood there on the corner.
Pretty brave. It was freezing cold. And there was a ton of people there. And it was right out in the open. It was awesome.
And I sang my little heart out. It was so fun. It's so much fun. I really did. I had a blast, Michael. And and it helped that you were there for moral support.
Of course.
Oh, my God. Wait, hey, I'm just going to look really quick. There's a bit of a delay with the feed. But is anybody here that was on the corner with us on Young and Dundas at 4 p.m. on Friday? Hi, Rick. Hi. There's a delay, so I'll just say hi as it waits.
No, I'm not a floating head anymore. I'm actually here. Look, I can push her.
I'm not sticking him in my cleavage. No.
Oh, I just saw Bob. Bob from UT Sound Department.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Was he there?
Yeah, he was there. I met him. I met Bob at a charity event about 3 months ago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So cool. You guys, you know what? I just want to start the show off by saying thank you so much. We are going to make a movie. Like, how freaking exciting is that? Like,
I know, it's so good, and this is working out so well, and you guys, we can't say thank you enough. It's just so heartwarming that you guys are this into it. It's just amazing.
It's so awesome. Did you guys notice I introduced a whole new aspect to the film today, the burlesque aspect? Because a lot of you guys don't know the actual full story, but when Mitch, Michael Cram, discovers that his child is not his own, he takes off on this adventure to go find the actual biological father. And in the little university town where Danny Baker is at school, there's a burlesque festival happening. And so half of the film takes place in this really colorful, like cabaret feeling burlesque festival atmosphere. So we just found this woman, this amazing chick. Her name's Coco Frambois. I put her picture up on Facebook today to advise us and bring us into the world of burlesque.
Hi,
and
girl.
Also to be the choreographer for the film. Like, this lady has such a spirit and such a soul. She's incredible. Mm-hmm. She's incredible. So we're so lucky to have her. Like, we're really psyched about that. So anyway, so that's why you're seeing sort of the burlesque aspect of the film starting to sort of interplay into the Indiegogo campaign right now.
Mm-hmm. And later on...
Hi, Kara.
Just before the hour is done, we're going to release the short film that Amy made with Sonya, Salomaa, and myself in it. And you get to see that on YouTube. So
yeah, and that's called Shooting Blanks.
It's just sort of the precursor, right, to what happens in the film.
It's about a 7-minute film that sort of sets up the situation and the scenario of the entire movie of The Space Between.
Yeah.
And so we're putting that on YouTube. And just to preface, I have pressed the button on the YouTube where it's for adult content, because it is. There's no nudity or anything, but he's in a fertility clinic, like giving a sample. So, but it's hilarious.
Hey, Captain Stable.
That's John. That's John Arnold.
Right? Oh, okay. Hi, John.
So if your computers or whatever are set to keep adult, you know, for your kids so that they can't watch adult content, you might have to go in and switch a button so you can actually watch the movie on YouTube. I didn't want to get in trouble. I mean, literally, there's no nudity or anything.
No, it's just adult situations.
It's adult content. Yeah. So that's that. So Max, Mr. Max Williams, hello. He calls me Mrs. Johnson. He's so cute. He's 11 years old. You're not allowed to watch it.
I had a question. So I'm sort of, if I look like I'm staring off into space, I'm trying to track the comments. We feel like, we didn't answer enough questions last time. So periodically, I'm going to look, not right now, but I'm going to look at the thing, and we're going to sort of jump in with some answers to your questions. But I saw that Michael Walter was at the White House when Amy Jo was the Pink Power Ranger in Dundas Square. What does that mean? How are you in?
Oh, Michael Walter, are you the one who wanted the different drafts of the script? I think that's Michael. Everybody, let Michael say hello.
Michael, we're waiting for you.
Oh, there's a
Michael's
delay.
Michael's gone to the bathroom.
There's a delay. But I pretty much, I think that's him. But why were you at the White House? That's so cool.
Yeah, anyway.
We'll try to read your answer, Michael.
There
okay,
he is.
What do you say?
What did you say? What were you doing at the White House? Were you taking a tour? Or were you? Or did you work there?
Hi,
John Bueno lives in Washington. I work for the PBS station, and we were doing a show there. Ah, I gotcha. So you live in Washington, Michael? Like it's PBS Washington?
So Michael Walter asked to have one of the perks be all the different drafts.
Ah, cool. All right.
So
thanks, Michael. Thanks for answering.
So we have about 4 different drafts at this point of the Space Between. And so I'm not sure what day we're going to launch that, but we're going to put it on Indiegogo. Indiegogo, we're going to put a perk of all the different drafts. So you can read the evolution of the script and where it's gone, which is kind of cool. But that one's for you, Michael. So.
Wait, this doesn't sound...
Shall we sing? Shall we sing a song?
So we're going to sing a song.
Let's do it. Because that's why we're here, right? To what we once face, you're a wonderful man. You're a wonderful man. You're a wonderful man. Oh, oh, to what we once had.
Yeah. Woo! Can I tell them what you said? What? So, can't. Cammy, my wife, Cammy. Amy Cammy, Jo.
Cammy, it's everybody.
Worst. It's the worst. Yeah, last night I'm over at my mom's house, and I called Cammy, my wife, Cammy, Mom. Try and explain that.
Oh,
And then I tried to correct myself and called my mom Cammy. I had nightmares last night. Anyway, last time Amy, Jo, and I got together to play, because it had been a while since we played these songs together. Amy Jo was like, let's try looking into each other's eyes while we play, because that's what people do in concert. And we
on
couldn't
Nashville,
do it.
On Nashville, right,
it.
Guys?
Yeah.
On Nashville,
so
they
like
try
this.
To like, oh, I can't do it. I can't even do it.
Yeah, we
You know what? The
do
next
it.
Song we sing together, we're actually going to do one more together, but we're going to look.
No.
Face to face. Dude, let's pretend we're in Nashville. Can we?
Okay, sure.
It's my favorite show. Okay. I love it. Oh, what are we going to do right now? We might pick a name out of a hat. All
right.
Shall we? So, the first name we're going to pick tonight. So, I'll explain because I don't know if everybody here, I'm assuming, but probably not. We did sort of like this raffle kind of thing on Indiegogo last night. For the space between. I'm just going to preface really quick because I don't know if anybody got a ticket to this stage at show that has no idea what we're talking about. So the space between is a feature film that I'm going to write and direct. Well, I've written and I'm going to direct it. And Michael Cram is starring in it. I also have a part in it. We're shooting in June. And right now we're raising money on Indiegogo to do this film. And we're like kicking butt with you guys because we're up to $95,000 right now. Mm-hmm. We exceeded our first goal. Our stretch goal is now $125,000. We don't know if we'll get there, but if we do, it'll be awesome because all the rest of the money for the budget is $250,000. All the rest of the money, we'll have to apply for grants and find other different avenues to get the money. Anyway, point being, yesterday we did a raffle where anybody who bought a $10 perk yesterday on Indiegogo.com for the space between, their name was put into a box. I say a hat, but it's a box. So there was 44 people, and one person put their name in twice. And whoever you are, your name is in there twice. I promise. So let me shake it up. So we're going to do this twice, but so the first time, this is for the Power Ranger Die Hard perk. It's a $300 perk on the Indiegogo campaign. My dear friend, Jen Bowen, bought the perk, and she gave it to me to give away. So that's why we're doing this.
Pretty cool, Jen.
Oh. Shaking it up.
Okay, this is a shout out to John Bueno and the Power Pack Squad.
Woo!
There you go.
Okay. Ready, guys? Oh my god, I'm nervous. I'm gonna have Michael pick. Okay. I'm pretty sure all 44 people are here. Just pick one, Michael, and don't drop him. He can be a little clumsy, this guy. I was on Flashpoint with him. He used to fall down all the time. All
right, here we go. We got it.
And a lot of guys didn't put your names. You put your email address.
Okay, so yeah.
Oh, it's a name.
Oh, and it's a familiar name.
Okay, Huang Li, or Huang, oh, he's so great.
Or is it Li Huang?
This guy is like working his butt off in the referral contest as well. We have a referral contest. I'm going to put the name up so you can see your name. You won.
Are you there? I recognize that name from my Twitter feed.
Yeah, right, John? This is so cool. This guy is awesome, and he has been promoting the Space Between Indiegogo campaign.
Yeah, that's why
like
I'm so
nobody's
familiar with his
business.
Name. Yeah.
So I'm really excited that you just won. And I don't even know if he's here, but I'm going to put his name up again.
But it doesn't matter. He doesn't have to be here, right?
No. Okay, good. Woo! And you, all these people know him, too, so this is really cool. So cool. We're going to... Jessica's here with us, too, guys. I'm going to give the name to Jessica. Our superstar producer. And she's going to put that in the whole thing. And we'll email you tomorrow just to reconfirm that you've won. And that's awesome. I'm so glad it was a familiar name. That's really cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anybody deserve
We're going to do the second perk, the Skype session, later. Okay? All right.
Let's take a question or two. What do you got for us? Somebody ask a question.
The hard thing about questions is there's such a delay. There's like a minute delay.
They're flying by, too, though. Is it a minute delay?
Is it really that long? At least 30 seconds.
Okay, let's do a... Okay.
You know what? Write some questions. Jessica will find a
good one. Okay, John Bueno, this is for you. John Bueno. I don't even know if Bueno's probably not your last name. John. John B. John underscore Bueno. Okay, this is a question for you, and we're doing this as a time to time the delay of the thing. So when I say now, I want you to write hi Amy, Joe, and Mike, okay? So now.
Yeah, we did this earlier, Michael. It's like 30 seconds, yeah. Well, really me and Jessica have done it. I've done it before.
Okay.
I'm gonna answer Prima's question.
I'm looking for it.
Favorite song you've ever... We're looking for... Oh, there he is. Nope.
That yay was probably This Is For You.
It's really long. So we're not going to do that. But Prima, my favorite song... We're both going to answer. My favorite song that I ever wrote is actually Cracker Jacks, the song we just sang. I just have so much fun when I sing it.
Thanks, John. Okay, so it is about 20 seconds.
Or more. What is your favorite song?
In the World?
That you've ever written.
Sympathy for the Devil, but Mick Jagger totally ripped me off.
what a nut.
My favorite song that I ever wrote.
I know my favorite song of Michael's, and I'm gonna ask him to sing it right now. And this song is actually featured in The Space Between.
Oh, right on.
Yep, he's gonna actually sing it in the movie, and I love it. So I'm gonna move over here, and it's called Humm.
All right, here we go. Whole world made of nothing. I guess I hum until I feel something, because I'm down until I get up. And whole world made of nothing. Your fundamental problem comes from playing with your sores. You think you find the answer, you cure your cancer, and now you're bored. Na na na. Whole world made of nothing. I na 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 na. Dead calm and the feeling's gone and I can't find it. Thanks, guys. I tried even looking into their eyes and I couldn't.
I love it. That song just like it chokes me up. I love it. I love, 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 love that song, you guys. And I'm so excited it's going to be on the soundtrack. And I don't know if you guys noticed, have you gone to the page yet, the Space Between Indiegogo page? If we reach the new goal, the 125,000, every single person from the beginning of the campaign, everybody will get a free download of the soundtrack. And this song is going to be on the soundtrack. Whoop, whoop. I'm nice. Really excited because I love it. And I don't know how many of you guys are on Twitter. Hopefully all of you. But please, please, go follow Michael. And,
oh, yeah,
and tell your friends
do.
To follow Michael.
Follow
He's
me.
He's Shark Attack. At Shark Attack.
Well, yeah, it's spelled funny, though. Maybe just look up my name, Michael Cram, and that it'll be at Shark Attack, spelt funny.
Yeah.
I had
or
to
go
leave
to
out
my
letters.
Twitter right now, because I just tweeted him on my Twitter page. On my Twitter page right now. I just tweeted you.
Hmm.
So his,
oh, good,
his thing is right there.
All
right. Right? How beautiful
What's
was
next?
That song?
What do you want to do? Thanks, Kara.
I'm just kidding.
Kara says she follows both of us already.
Awesome. Love it. You guys, I feel like singing. I'm going to sing a song.
All right.
I wish. What are the other songs we sang together that one time? You just hop in. Just hop. Play along if you feel like it.
Okay.
I'm going to do...
I
can't remember the ones that we did. Did we do Dancing in Between?
I can't remember.
Got so scared and made me cry. The world took me for a ride. Got so scared and made me laugh. Dancing in between, 'cause I got nowhere to hide. Romancing the seas on my battered up insides. Wonderful is the falling of a broken dream when it printed on a cover of an AR magazine. I'll stomp my hand, yo baby, I'll clap my feet, 'cause there's always another. Dancing in between, 'cause I got nowhere to hide. Romancing the seams on my battered up insides. Dancing all in between. Michael, I wrote that right after I was fired from Love Janice off Broadway.
Really? Yeah. That sounds like a story.
Have you ever been fired?
Yes. Yes, I have.
I'm sure we all have. You know what? A friend of mine said when I got fired, I was so upset, and he said, "Okay, you know what? Now you've made it. Now you're a real actor."
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got fired. I got fired once. I was hired to do this. I'm gonna tell the story. I got fired to do this CBC radio drama thing, and it was a documentary for hockey. It was a documentary with dramatized things, but it was a radio thing, and they needed someone to do the announcer parts. You know, the old timey sort of, shoots it down the boards. They gave me this stack of things, and I went in. I was doing all sorts of voices, but this was one of them, the main ones that I was hired to do. And I had a stack of like 20 pages, and I went into the sound booth, and I started doing it, and they kept on directing me. And there's 5 people outside the sound booth. They were so friendly and so nice when I came in, and really helpful when I was in the booth. And I read 1.5 of these pages after like 2 or 3 times each segment, and they gave me some direction. And then they went, "All right, Michael, thank you. That was great." And I was like, "But we haven't even really started the main stuff." No, that was great. Thank you.
And this wasn't an audition.
No, it was a job. I had been waiting for 45 minutes to get in before the guy before me was done. And I went in and I did it, and they told me, "That's great. That was great. Thank you. That's all we need." I was like, "But there's 20 other pages there." They're like, "Yeah."
Yeah.
And I came out and I went up to them.
When was that?
Oh, it was years ago. It was like 5 or 6 years. Oh, maybe even 10 years ago. God. It was a long time. Time goes by fast. But I went out to say goodbye to them all, and none of them would even look at me in the eye. They were just like, "That was great, Michael.
That was really good. Anyway, yeah."
And I went out, I called my agent, I said, "I think I just got fired."
Oh. Yeah. It's a bummer when it happens, but it makes us stronger, guys. You know what?
Yeah.
When crappy things happen, it's like a really, honestly, and I'm not even being silly, I try to find it a really good opportunity to learn how to love.
Uh-huh.
No, I'm serious. To take that opportunity to like try to, no, I'm really serious. When something crappy happens, take the opportunity to learn how to like shift the energy, and the people involved just like, you know, say thank you for giving you the opportunity to like have that lesson in your life.
Yeah. I think failure is an important thing, right?
Right.
I think you're way braver than I am though.
You wouldn't wear a Pink Ranger costume and go out to the middle?
You guys should have seen this yesterday, man. It was
on Friday.
It was so Friday. It was so awesome. It was so awesome. You had to be there, but and the people that were there were so appreciative, and it was just, it was really cool.
They were very appreciative. Very appreciative. Okay, how about Michael sing another song, and then let's pick a Skype session. The winner of the raffle for the Skype session. What do you guys think?
That sounds great to me. I'm going to sing a song. Where is it? I'm going to sing a song called Clean It Up.
I just heard it. It's so pretty.
I haven't played it in a while, so I may screw up. So you guys will forgive me, though.
That's all
right. We're all friends here. Yeah. We're just sitting around the living room hanging out, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's what
I'm okay. Decision, turn off the television and the sun's too bright. You've been living in a lie, you've been living in a compromise. No one's buying all the lies, no one's buying all your alibis. They have it out for you. Maybe sanity is overrated. They have it out for you. Protect your loved ones from collateral destruction. Clean it up, clean it up, clean it up. You've been up all night. Make a decision, turn off the television, and the sun's too bright. Taking them to bed with you. Let them say what they will as you take another pill or two. They have it out for you. Maybe sanity is overrated. They have it out for you. Protect your loved ones from collateral destruction. Clean it up, clean it up, clean it up. You've been up all night. Make a decision, turn off the television, and the sun's too bright.
Song is amazing, right? And so people were asking, I was kind of writing down questions. Do you have any of your music on iTunes?
I don't have any on iTunes, but I can absolutely, I have a MySpace page. If you just look up my name usually on Google, somewhere down in that line on the first or second page after Google gives its results, there's a MySpace page. I think it's myspace.com/MichaelCramMusic.
He's so old school.
I know. No, you know what? You know what? It's a great place just to put up your songs. It's the only reason I have a MySpace page. But
it is a great place to put up songs.
Yeah,
it is a great place. It's a great somebody else page. Asked you, are you on Instagram?
I'm not on Instagram. Well, I am, but I never
apparently,
use it.
Apparently, JDF told me Instagram is where it's at.
Yeah?
So, yeah.
Okay. Well, maybe I will be after tonight. Hey, look, Twitter practically ruined my life. I mean, I feel like Twitter's this great responsibility. Like, you've got to check in, you've got to be active on it, or what's the point of
having it? Oh, no, but the thing about Instagram that actually JDF told me was that, so when you post something on Instagram, you can send it to your Twitter. So you only have to do one post. So you do post on Instagram.
Oh,
and
yeah,
you can send it to
I heard
Facebook
that. I
and
heard
Twitter
that.
At
yeah,
the same time.
I did hear
I don't
that.
Know. Some people don't like that, but some people don't, you know, different people follow different
Aaron
things.
Wood just talked about a podcast called Nerdversity. What is Nerdversity? You get back to me.
Okay. I just wanted to tell you.
Yeah.
Oh, what was the name of that song?
Oh, that's called Clean It Up.
Clean It Up. And you know what? I asked him tonight. I was like, do you have another song you can play? And he played that. I'm like, can that go on the soundtrack too? Because how awesome is that song, right? So I'm hoping I'm going to get him to record that acoustically.
Oh, I can't wait.
Use
Are you
that
kidding?
On the soundtrack as well.
That sounds fantastic.
I love it. I love it. All right, let's pick a name out of a hat.
Okay, here we go again. Let's get Jessica to pick this one.
Okay. We're going to pick the... do you guys want to say hi to Jessica? Anyway, she doesn't like to be on camera. She hates it. You don't want
to. Like my wife. My wife doesn't like being on camera.
She
yet.
Hates it.
No?
You know what? Let's not make her feel funny.
She's
but we have to pick it here. Michael, you're going to have to pick it.
Okay.
Okay, so this, again, is for the Skype session that my friend Deb Neal bought. Very nice lady. Bought it. And she has given it up. Been giving it away. And so... somebody in here.
And there's only 43 names in there now.
There's only 43 now.
Is Huang Li eligible?
No, no. There's actually 44 names because somebody did it twice.
Okay.
No, he's not eligible.
Everybody's saying
hi
to you, Jessica. Okay, here we go. Is that one or two?
Drum roll. Oh, wait. I have drums. Hang on. Put it back in. Oh, no. Don't put it back in. You
got
it. You got it.
This is somebody's. Okay. I got two there. I got to drop one. Okay.
Drumroll.
Okay, this is an email because whoever it was didn't give their
Let's
name.
See if I know it. I don't recognize it.
Okay, so here, if you're listening, it's and this is you. aprils.sweet4@gmail.com. Who's that? aprils.sweet4@gmail.com. Here it is.
Aprils, are you here?
Where is it? There it is.
Are you here, April?
Whoops. I'm sorry. I'm not being very good at this. There we go. Anyway, that's the name. That's the winner right there.
We have bongos. That's the name. That's the name. Her name is April. All right. Anyway.
All right.
Congrats, April. Congrats. April's not here. Ding, 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 ding. Okay, I'm handing that to Jessica. Keep in safe place. Right? Oh, so you guys know April. Do you guys know April?
You guys know
Lucky April? Lucky April of Aprils. That's who it's for. Will you sing Relief with me?
I don't think I know.
I know, but on Nashville, they just jump in with each other.
Well, they're better musicians.
They do.
They're clearly better.
They just, like, they don't even know the song, and suddenly they're just singing it.
I have to take a quick bathroom break.
Okay. Michael's going to the bathroom, and I'm going to sing Relief.
It's good because it's real.
Michael's
right?
Michael's going to relief himself.
Oh,
and,
perfect.
And I'm going to sing Relief, and I don't have the... Oh, there we go. I know, right? My inspiration for Relief. First of all, I just want to say when earlier I saw Melissa Hawkins' thing go by when I was talking about failure and all that stuff, and you said something about your mom. Her mom was killed in a car accident, I think, or walking across the street. I remember that was like 2 years ago. Anyway, you said that you saw a lot of blessings after your mom was killed. And so, you know what? We've all had our tragedies in our life. And so I wrote Relief really basically out of the tragedies I've had in my life. And yeah, so this one's for you, Melissa. I'm going to dedicate this song to you. Oh my God, I do remember Melissa when she made a joke about Relief. Laura Lynn made a joke about, but it wasn't potty talk. It was more like shooting blanks talk. What am I talking about? I don't even know what I'm talking about. Okay. So, little sip of water. Trying hard to find belief, so our bones can keep on standing through all this grief. We're all just pretending, and it's hard to see. Underneath this exterior, you're just like me. We're all just pretending. We're all all just pretending. We're all just pretending.
I jumped in right at the end there.
Yeah! Michael jumped in!
That's what I do, I jump in for 7 seconds.
I want to sing another song with you. Let's just do Bright Lights Now. Let's do it.
Okay.
Is that okay? We're just gonna do Bright Lights. Well, I know it. Whatever. Okay, here we go. Ready? This one is for... Andre. Is Andre here? You know what? It's too far away for it to be for Andre. I mean, for him to be here and up. This is for Andre anyway, guys. You can tell him later. Oh, and Rick. You know what? This is for Rick and Andre. They are helping us so much. Rick has done all the graphics for the campaign.
Right.
All the graphics are done by Rick. And then Andre has been helping getting all the video messages and the voice messages out to you guys. Like, yeah. I'm not singing this to you because it's kind of mean and sad if I was. It's just for you.
Not to you, it's for you.
You don't know me. Oh, that's what I tell myself. And all the pain that I've endured is in a box up on a shelf. I don't need you anymore. Yes, that's what I said. And all the promises I made are just stories in my head. And when your spirit
supposed to kiss and they cut the commercial.
Right. Oh, damn it. We should have done that the whole song. You know what? The next song you sing, I want you to sing it right to me. I'm just going to look at you.
Okay. I don't know what I'm going to sing next. I don't think I have anything else I can
sing. You got one in your old little carpet bag. Come on. You can pull one out. Oh, my God. That show Nashville, right? So good. Okay. I know I keep promoting the show Nashville. I'm obsessed with it. And you know what's so fun? Is there was a show on Thursday. I haven't watched it yet. Guess what I'm doing tonight? It's like a piece of candy waiting for me. I love it. Okay. Where are we at? We have 13 minutes, guys. Julia Roberts. I know. Huh? I don't remember. I mean, I have it. What else? All right. The only way I'm doing Julie Roberts is Michael has to jump in with me.
Jump in.
You have
I'll
to.
Play
I
play another song
gonna...
at the same time. All right.
We'll just make it a piece of crap. I don't even have it in front of me because I was not planning on singing it. And we're here for Shooting Blanks, by the way. You guys, it's launching. So as soon as the show's done, Jessica is going to press the little button. Or we have another computer over here. And we're going to press it on YouTube, and we're going to press the little button, and it would be really awesome, I think, if, where could we do sort of, like, I would love to have the feedback. I guess on the YouTube, there's the place where you can write in the comments. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll go there, and we'll check it out, and,
No, I never had a hard time with the Flashpoint gear. Why is people asking me that?
He was not the first time. Very clumsy.
Oh, well, I was clumsy, but it wasn't like a problem with the actual gear.
Oh, no. But he would fall down all the time. He'd be like running. Oh,
my
God.
Why.
The worst
I don't know
story,
why,
the,
though.
Or
I'm
the
not
best
that
story.
Uncoordinated. I'm pretty coordinated.
And this wasn't your fault, but do you remember the time poor Michael suddenly, all of a sudden, had like projectile vomiting happening.
Oh, my God.
In the middle of the scene.
No, it wasn't suddenly.
The Royal York.
It wasn't sudden. No.
Wasn't that the...
Oh, yes. That was a different time. Sorry. So
he
I vomited a couple of times.
The first AD, he's like,
You know what it was? It was the broccoli salad. It was the broccoli salad. It was just sitting in the sun, and I was like, I'm so hungry, I'll eat it anyway. And then I ate it, and we're in the middle of a scene. I'm like, guys, I gotta go. And I've started running, and one of our assistant directors who's got, like, first of all, I've got a microphone on, and our assistant directors has a headset. And they're concerned with us being on set, right? So I go bolting to the washroom.
We have to show
I stick my head in the first. Toilet. I start throwing up. And the
he's like,
assistant director is like this on the walkie-talkie. Oh, yeah. He's throwing up. Oh, my God. There's so much. We're going to be here for a little bit. Okay, set up the next shot.
Five. Everybody take five.
Can we write Michael out of the scene? He's literally standing above me doing this. Ah, Michael Johnson. He's a classic, that guy.
I know he is. Alright, so the chords are... Oh, you know what, Max? I can't even remember. I'm not going to be able to just pull this one out of my hat.
Okay, just let's give it a bash.
I want to be Julia Roberts in the movies. I want to make you laugh and make you cry. Make you want to be me. And I want to steal all of her beauty. Truth, them are the facts. Weird. I'm a self-obsessed little brat. That's the deal. I got no clue. It's a sort of disease from my unrequited idea. Tears all over my feels like that big, but it's all right. It's okay, guys. Because I'm going to direct. I'm going to direct a movie. I'm so excited. Yay.
Oh, my God. Oof. We're getting to the end here.
I know. We have 7 minutes left. I don't know.
You guys are so interesting that the time just flies by.
Let's see.
I want to take a question.
We can't because there's a time delay.
I know, but a question's going to come up now that I said that, okay. And I'm going to answer it. I'm just going to interrupt you and answer it.
Okay, so, all right. Again, shooting blanks, adult content in it. This is a prequel, 7-minute prequel to The Space Between. It sets up the situation. It's funny, and at the same time, I think it's a bit heartfelt, and it gets a little sad at the end. But anyway, it's... And Michael and Sonya Salomaa star in it, and they're awesome. They're awesome in it. And they will be the stars of The Space Between that we're going to shoot. I've seen a lot of questions on Facebook kind of not understanding. Like, the movie's not done yet, The Space Between. We're shooting in June. And so I'll give you the time frame. I'll give you a breakdown of the time frame right now so everybody knows. For the Indiegogo. Indiegogo ends November 23rd. Okay? At November 23rd, we're going to send out an email to most everybody for the particular perk that you got and get information, like for the headshot, what do you want on it, or setting up times for Skype sessions, all this stuff. That's going to happen probably the end of November. In December, anything that was like pre-done, like the Power Ranger photo book, the acting photo book, all that stuff will be sent out, and hopefully it gets there. You know, the mail in December is crazy. Hopefully it gets there. The Space Between physical package will not get there until the following year because we're going to shoot the movie in June. Okay? In June, we're shooting The Space Between. We're spending the summer editing, color correcting, music, all that. Our goal is to have the film done end of November 2015. At that point, we will have the soundtrack, and we're going to send everybody, if we reach the goal, the soundtrack, or whoever bought the Space Between downloadable package. You will get your soundtrack at that point. And then the movie will be released probably winter 2016, depending on if we do a festival route. If we do a festival route, we might have to hold back on actually giving the movie out at that point until the festival route.
So how would that work? So if we shot it in June of 2015, it wouldn't make it until, like, it wouldn't be ready to submit to TIFF until the following year, right?
Winter. Yeah, well.
So it would be like, it would be TIFF 2016, it would
if
be
got
submitted.
Into TIFF. Yeah. But we'll start submitting. Or we might get a distribution
deal. We'd have to wait
deal.
A whole year and a half is what I'm saying.
Yeah, well, no, because the movie will be done in November and then we'll start submitting in the winter. Or if we don't go the festival route and we just get a distribution deal, then the movie will be hopefully in theaters and VOD, downloadable onto iTunes. And, you know, we haven't really figured out the afterlife of the film yet. We're still creating the film. So that's that.
I got a couple of questions I got in my head here.
Yeah.
So first, yes, I was on Rain. That was me. It was supposed to be a few episodes, but I committed the crime, got caught for the crime, confessed to the crime, and then got charged with the crime. There's nothing left to do but behead me, so that was over. And Amy Jo, do you miss Flashpoint?
You know what? I miss the whole family. I do. It was an awesome gig. It was 5 years of just like...
Yeah, it was pretty fun. It was stressful at times. It was a hard... Like, as far as acting goes, it was a hard job.
It was a
within
hard
the
shoot.
Context of what we do is pretty
and,
easy.
And mostly because, guys, we live in Toronto and the weather.
Yeah.
And we're shooting in the middle of winter.
They really wanted us to look as cool as possible, so we're wearing these skinny little outfits, and it was, you know, parka weather.
But you know what, guys? For Amy Jo, who was the only woman on the show, loved wearing... I didn't have to go through wardrobe fittings. All I had to do... Like, I didn't have to worry
what do you
about
mean?
This. I just put on my little SRU uniform,
yeah.
And I was good to go, man.
You were warm?
I didn't have to worry about my weight.
Oh. Yeah, the rest of us were obsessed.
You guys were. But I was just like, put on my long johns, and I don't know,
yeah.
That thing just like sat well.
But yeah, of
like,
course we miss it. It's nice to be doing different things after that long, I have to
the
say
cool
that.
Pants.
But
the cool very, pants.
The cool pants, yeah. And a lot of people are asking, and I'm assuming these are people that are maybe young people, how adult is it and can I watch it?
Oh, yes. Hannah just asked that. She's 17. Yeah. Okay, so here's the deal. There is no nudity, but it does take place, shooting blanks, in a fertility clinic. So basically, it's like, you know, Hannah, you're 17 years old. If your parents allow you to watch adult content and films, then you're fine. You can you can watch it. Max, who's 11, you know, it's probably not appropriate.
Yeah. Wait a couple of years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like any sort of rated R movie, right? It's not a family movie. The space between is going to be really fun and you know, we're at a burlesque festival half the time and there's going to be some fun things happening. So, is that
what
right,
else?
Jess?
Did
I say that
more
right?
People
I
mean, are saying,
will the
John,
movie be rated
John
R?
Bueno is saying, hi, Jessica. She says
Jessica
hi back,
hi.
John.
I'm just gonna get the from the producer. Is shooting?
I think it's gonna be rated R in the States.
Yeah.
Michael in a cup.
What?
Someone said so.
Michael in a cup. Yeah. What?
Basically.
It is Michael in a cup.
Mm-hmm.
It is exactly you.
Yeah.
In the States, it'll probably be rated R, and then up in Canada, it's like N17.
If I was
N17.
In your living room, I would leave while it was on. Let's put it that way. I wouldn't be super comfortable sitting beside people watching this.
Max, how come Jessica is Miss Adams? Oh, because I'm married. But my husband's last name isn't Johnson. Anyway, Max calls me Mrs. Johnson.
Ooh, Michael Walter. One Michael, one cup. No.
Okay, Michael Walter. You need to back off a little bit. No, I'm kidding. Okay, so what are we doing? You guys, we have 1 minute left here. And we could... You know what? What do you guys want to do? Do you want to sing another song? Do you have another song?
I can't think of anything right now that would be sort of... It's.
I have a song that I can sing that you could actually... It's easier to play than
okay.
Julia Roberts.
We're
going to
go
just,
out on a song?
No, we have like 10... There's a little encore. We're just going to hang out with these guys until they all leave us. So, I don't know what these chords are because I have a capo on, but I'm going to do Panic.
I'll just hear you.
Hey, by the way, so when it does go, let's just wait till it goes and then I press the button because you have to press the button to keep it going. You're allowed to stay. You don't have to stay, but we will go over a little bit if you all want to. Yeah, Panic. Are we? Yeah, right? Mm. Michael, I can even like put the lyrics here and you can just like make up your own tune. Oh my God, so fun.
Okay.
Right, guys? Encore time.
At least it's a
I'm
subject.
Press the button.
At least it's a subject
boom.
I know a lot about.
Panic.
Yeah.
He is so Mitch. Like, I'm so excited for Michael to play.
I basically just
role.
Have to go be a slightly less mature me. And I'm only saying that to make myself feel better.
Slightly less. Okay. What is this world that we all have to bear? Is it the same as it is for you? Are we going anywhere? I don't know. We all wake up in the morning and we all take a breath and we all search for comfort. We all have our tastes. How are you? Pick up the pieces and kiss them goodbye. Keeps on moving, you don't even try. Hear the dandelion hairs, it's Diana Wilson, it dies, and all the seeds fly away. I have my coffee, I have my car, I got my guitar, and I got up my love, how about you? I said I have my car. Because my doggy Lucy died. I have my coffee. Should I get my computer and launch Shooting Blanks?
Yeah, I think it's time.
What do you think?
What am I supposed to say? No? No. Don't.
Okay, let me get my computer. Got my computer right here.
How did they find it?
YouTube.
Go to YouTube.
Actually, go to the Indiegogo.com, the space between page, and I'm going to put it on there right now. Yep. Because I could put a little playlist, the space between playlist.
Okay.
It's in the playlist. Let me see.
I know I said we were going to answer a bunch of questions, but the feed is going by so quickly, I don't even have time to read them. It's just like flying by. It's like a ticker tape just going...
Okay, you guys are going to do something weird because I forgot to put flash on my computer. I'm going to, like, come in here and do it on here, but you can still see us, but I just can't see you. La, 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 la. Can you see me? YouTube. Okay. And go to my channel. Videos.
Mm-hmm.
Where is it? Shooting Blanks.
Oh no.
Here we go, guys. Here we go. Shooting Blanks. Edit. Oop. Video manager. One sec. And Shooting Blanks. Wait, oh. It's happening, I promise. These computers, I tell ya. in my video manager. Edit. Private.
Public.
Okay, and then I'm going to put it on to the space between playlist. Publish.
Oh. Now can they see it?
Now they can.
You guys should be able to find it now.
Okay, we did it.
All right. Thank you guys for such a good show. This was
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, thank you, John, and yeah. Sam, and Steve, and Max, and
Christine,
Melissa, and
G.
Kara,
Shangley, and Aiden Platt, and John
Christina,
Harrison, Kevin Tubbs,
Nita,
Lucky Lauren,
John Bueno, Richard,
Michael Walter,
Lana
Fry, JC,
Aaron,
Marie Mancuso,
True
Marina
Blue,
Sokova,
Talita. Oh, Talita just did an article today. She's from Brazil. She just put up something about the space between, which is pretty cool.
Oh, I'm going to Brazil next week. I'm going to go spend 7 weeks in Brazil with my my wife's family. We live just outside of Sao Paulo.
He's married
can't
to
wait.
A Brazilian, this guy.
Yeah. I
awesome
love it there.
Lady.
I can't wait to be there.
Lucky Monkey, Michael. Sonya. Hi, Sonya. Samantha. Kara. Lucky Lauren.
Talita. Kevin Tubbs. Janet. Glaze.
Jennifer Bowen! Emma and Gracie. Oh my god, hi guys! Sorry. Barney, Vincent, Samantha, hi, Gracie, hi, Emma. Okay.
I just saw the name Sam Maynard go by, Tommy Castle, Mike Ammo.
Yeah, guys.
Alright, guys, thank you so much.
There's 11 minutes and they're gonna want us to stay on here.
Oh yeah, okay. Oh, okay. We're back.
You know what? Let's just sing some more. Right?
Okay.
A little sing.
Do you know anything? Do you know any covers?
Yeah, you play one. You play one, Michael. We had this discussion earlier. Both of us don't know any covers.
Yeah.
We're really boring at campfires.
Yeah. Everybody always goes, take the guitar. Mike plays guitar. Amy Jo plays guitar. And then 5 minutes later, don't you know anything we can sing along with?
Do you know what? Sometimes I like to pretend I know covers and I sing songs my own way. Mm. Give me a song, Michael.
Okay.
I'm going to take covers right now.
Okay, why not the first song I ever wrote? Made Famous by the Rolling Stones. Sympathy for the Devil.
Oh, no, but give me an easy one that I know all the words.
Oh.
Oh, Clear Blue Day. Thanks,
Talita.
I was
stuck
there.
You know all the words, too.
You can play with this one, too. It's very easy. It's just C and G.
Okay.
On a clear blue...
Yeah.
Button. Sorry. On a clear blue day, does the sun get in your eyes? Blind of our faith, does the light hypnotize? Please forgive me, I felt the rain. Within the sunlight, oh, I felt a drop of pain. Yeah, what do you feel? I know by now, it better be this time. Give me love, give me light. I've been traveling for so long. Overdrive, 100 miles. I deserve a little bit of this light, a little smile. I deserve a little bit of you. Sorry. My feet in the sand, there's an empty breeze. Familiar wind, well, he blew out. Wanna run, I wanna chase it. Wanna swim the seven seas. Familiarity, won't you come? Won't you come running back to me? I know by now, better be this time. Give me love, give me light. I've been traveling for so long. Overdrive, 100 miles. I deserve a little bit of this life, a smile. I deserve a little bit of you. Congratulations, Lauren, on getting married. Oh. Sing a cover. Oh my god, what should I sing? Come on, let's do a cover. Do you know any songs?
I don't know any.
Like, I know songs, but when like you go to sing, I'm like, I don't know any.
Lover!
Oh, no, 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 no.
Where have you been? Gonna go with the bright lights in the big city of me. That's all I know, cause I can't sing this song. One of them is desire. I pretty much know every song
of
someone
like,
else.
I go all day.
Every YouTube one. No, I won't. On principle. No.
Come on, well, I go. Come on, that's like a good campfire song. We can go in rounds with it. My grandma says your grandma.
No, we're not going to do that. I'm putting my foot down. We have to keep some, like, a lid on the quality control here.
Isn't it funny?
You know, this is like when you're about to introduce somebody at a party and you're like, you see people coming and you're like, oh my God, what are their names? And you can't remember it because you have to remember it. I'm sure I know 20 songs, but I can't remember them now.
Like, no. Oh, I know one. You with your sad eyes. Don't be... See, I'm terrible at karaoke, too. That was,
Oh, boy.
He doesn't like
it's gonna
choice.
Be a long 5 minutes.
Oh, my God. Lexi's song. I don't know Lexi's song, Jacqueline. Come on. That's Macy. What's her name? Macy. She's really good. My friend Lexi. Okay. Wouldn't you want to be my lady? Travel down this lonely highway. Down the only road I know. Never alone, but still so. Wouldn't you want me to be your lover? Okay, that one's boring. Okay. I'll try another one.
What else should we do?
I got one.
Oh, here's the first song I ever loved.
It's been hard to see. Find myself a king. Cause it would be a shame, you see, to spend it all worthlessly. Oh, I'll be bankrupt from youth. Cause it's been Squadron, and they are amazing supporters, and they are hugely behind the space between and helping us do this thing. You guys, thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, there's really no way to say thank you properly. You guys are just amazing, and thank you. We're going to make a movie. That's how we're going to say thank you.
Yeah. Right? And we got two weeks left of the Indiegogo campaign, the space between. 2 weeks left to have fun, and I don't know, there's some cool stuff coming up as well. And you guys, thank you. Thank you, Mary. Hi, Mary.
When's one of the next one of these?
Oh, November 23rd, guys. We're actually doing 25 seconds. November 23rd is another Stage It show. Get your ticket, because that night is the last day of the campaign, and also the $500 perk for Amy Jo's artwork, where I'll write a song and